Martin Truex Jr. won last year's Coca-Cola 600. Who will end up in victory lane this time? We'll have our predictions coming up. But next.
It's a very addicting hobby, and it was back then to me. And like I said, I'm not over it yet.
See how slot car racing brings out the kid in a member of one of NASCAR's most famous families.
Yeah, I could come over here by myself and just run it for, you know, for hours.
All right, it's been said that racing gets in your blood. It has been for Eddie Wood, the second generation owner and operator of the famed Wood Brothers number one race team.
All right, but his love of racing extends beyond NASCAR and back to when, Danny, he was a kid, and his love of slot car racing. Recently, we went up to Stuart, Virginia to check it out.
There are some vintage race cars and plenty of classic photos inside the Wood Brothers old race shop in Stuart, Virginia. There's also a 1960-style slot car racetrack, which is the pride and joy of Eddie Wood and his brother Len.
Yeah, I could come over here by myself and just run it for, you know, for hours.
It has become a great stress relief from the high-pressure world of NASCAR.
You stand there, you don't want to sit down. Your feet don't hurt, you're on concrete. None of that happens. You're in a zone with it.
Eddie ordered the track as a way to commemorate one of the team's biggest moments.
Win the Daytona 500!
Winning the 2011 Daytona 500 with Trevor Bayne.
When it all got said and done, you know, a year or so later, Lena and I said, you know, we ought to get something just for that. So I was addicted to slot car racing when I was 13, 14 years old. I said, let's get a slot car track. Okay, and Lynn was too. So let's do that.
And he hasn't regretted the decision once. What started out as a tribute has blown up into a hobby that's fueled by memories from when he was a kid.
You know, you start looking, of course, on eBay to the old slot cars. I bought one brand new one. I'm ashamed to tell you what I gave for it, but I got it. But it was still in the wrapper. It was like $15 in the 60s, and I don't even want to say how much I paid for it. I'm kind of embarrassed about it, but anyway, I got it.
There were tracks in and around North Carolina and Virginia, sort of like bowling alleys. Maybe it's a good thing the Woods didn't have their own track back in the day.
Lynn and I were working at the race shop after school and at night, and this would have probably tried to take into, you know, got into that time, so we'd have probably got it taken away from us pretty quick.
The modern track even has a computer so you can follow your lap time.
There it is, 292. Right, get the most brake you can get, which right. That's what you want. So just about half throttle it around. And
after a few driving tips, Eddie, Ford PR specialist Dan Zacharias, and I went head to head in a 50-lap race. Eddie took it easy on the rookies.
He's not getting in a hurry.
And old KC went to victory lane.
You beat us for two laps.
Yeah!
And you can certainly see why he likes it so much.
We don't get to play with it a lot, but, you know, just special times, Christmas. And every year we bring our pit crew and our race team in here, and we have a little race contest, you know, because you can race eight people at a time. And but it's just like the ones in the 60s. Just a lot of fun.
Yes, it was a lot of fun.
Should have got a trophy.
Yeah, that's right. All right, when we come back, who made it into NASCAR's Hall of Fame? The announcement just made.